In this video, I'm going to show you how to add a rich text control into your model-driven app. Here we have our equipment. I've got a description of it, but what if I have more to say than that and I want to apply bullets and formatting and numbers and so on? You can totally do that. Let me show you how. As always, I'm starting in my solution here and I'm going to go into the equipment table, navigate through to that main form that I'm working on. Now, the description is already in there. I've got this set up as a multi-line text field. And if I hover over it, you'll see there are different components here that I can add. We drop down here, select Add Component, and I'm going to add this rich text editor control. You'll see that this allows you to add this control to multi-line text, text, and text area fields. So whichever one of those you set up, this option is available to you. Let's grab that. We are going to click done, give it a second, and look, there we go. Now, you'll see, because we've got a lovely WYSIWYG editor here, and I will zoom up, that it's put the column name to the side. So first of all, I'm going to hide that label, and now we've got that across the screen. Perhaps I want to bring this into another section and give it even more room here. So let's add a component. We'll grab a one column section, drag that up so that it is under the image in the middle here, and then I'm going to grab my description, pop it in there, and we can give this whole section a name here called description. All right, let's just zoom back out, and I reckon that's looking pretty good. Let's save and give it a test. Publish our changes, and now in my app, instead of this, I have this much better situation. My rich text control here allows me to change my font size, bold, and so on, and a bunch of other options here as well. So now I could go in and put in the features of the chair, add a bulleted list, and add different colors or anything I like in there. I was working there with a text area column, which has a maximum of 4,000 characters. If you want something much bigger, here's another thing you can do, is to create a multi-line text field, which gives you a much, much bigger scope. So I've got that already set up here. Again, I go in and add my rich text editor control component. Let's hide the label and we'll save and publish that. And now you'll see we've got the rich text editor control taking up most of the screen. I can add an image in there as well as all of those other formatting options. So plenty to play with here. For more tips and tricks on how to get the most out of model-driven apps, make sure you check out my next tutorial. Thanks very much for watching.